Drop those hips, bring your chin to your chest, and round the world in your forehead to your knees. to the runner's lunge, or back towards the sky, and continue on through into the runner's lunge. You can always drop to that knee, and then swing it up and through to modify. We're all making it that runner's lunge, try to place this forward. And I'll shift that body weight forward, and bring that right foot to meet your left. Into your forward fold. And then we're going to lock out your knees, one minus a little bit of bend. Allow the head to hang heavy, shake it up, shake it down. And as you go, lower your rib time. Inhale, hands up overhead. Draw the shoulders back and down. Exhale, back foot and let go. Inhale, hands up overhead. Draw the shoulders back and down. And swan dive forward with flat back. Come into that nice and tadasana forward fold. Stand as we shot up with our left. We need to shoot that left leg back into the runner's lunge. We want to keep our sides even. Whatever we do on the right side, we can do to the left. Now, we're going to place our hands flat on the mat. Take your right foot and take it back to meet your left into your plank. You're tucking in your tailbone here. You're lifting the crown of your head towards the front rib. You're making your plank nice and long. Now with your shoulders stacked over your wrists, you're going to hug the ribcage halfway down, then back up, then down up and through for upward facing dog. Eye face goes up, shoulders back and down. Now let's tuck those top up. Tuck those toes, lift the hips, and melt the chest towards the thighs. Relax into your downward dog. Now from here, let's go ahead and shift the body weight forward to that plank position. Now bend at your knees, drop to the knees. Now, just like before, let's sit our booty onto our heels, walking our hands towards our thighs, palms face up, bringing those shoulders back and down. Let's come to our intention. This could be a word, a phrase, something that's going to help you get through your personal practice. Let's set a word for our intention. Close your eyes. Set it strong by inhaling through the nose and exhaling through the nose. I'm going to do a couple of shoulder stretches before we move forward. They're pretty easy. You're going to take your hands, place them out in front of you. Now you're going to go ahead and pretend like you're clapping your hands together, but instead, your right hand is going to miss your left hand. Your right hand is going to go over your left hand. So now it looks like your hands are crossed in front of you. You're going to switch your palms so they're facing each other. Now we're going to close our hands together like if we're going to clap. Interlace our hands. From here, we bring our hands forward under and then up and through towards our face. Now doing this, you want to go very, very slowly. You don't want any pinching or pulling sensation. Once it's all the way through, play with it and see how far you can go. want to bring those shoulders back and down. It should feel really good. Give you a nice opening in the shoulders. Bringing it back nice and gentle the same way that we went out. Now I'm a big believer in symmetry, so we need to switch. Since we did our right hand over our left hand this time, or last time, now we're going to do our left hand over our right hand. So they pretend like they're going to clap. Interlace those fingers. Bring that fist towards the face, then up, out, and through, getting a nice stretch in those shoulders. This time, the left arm is on top, right arm is on bottom. Same way that we went out, we want to go back through. Very nice. Now, everyone should be in that nice seated position. Let's place our hands back on our thighs, palms face up. Bring those shoulders back down. It should feel really good. Now, we're going to inhale those hands up overhead. Draw those shoulders back and down. Hinge forward. Place our hands flat to the mat. We want our fingers spread out wide. We're going to tuck our toes, lift our hips, and mount our chest towards our thighs. Now from here, I want you to tippy-toe all the way up to your hand. So one step at a time, coming to that Uttanasana forward fold. Feel free to wiggle around, sit your down for your Uttanasana forward fold, nice and strong. Now from here, take your hands, place your palms face up. I want you to bend at your knees as much as you need to get your hands down there towards your feet. You're bringing your palms face up. And now you're stepping on your palms, trying to get your toes to touch your wrist crease. Now remember, bend at your knees as much as you need to get down there. Once you're down there, you can start straightening up those legs. Allow the head to be heavier. And just like before, shake it a little, shake it yes, shake it no. This is Bhadrasana, if you need a little bit more here. We're going to bend our elbows to the sides of the room. This should help you get a little bit further. If you need even more, start elevating those hips forward above the head. Bringing that weight into the balls of the feet. Now carefully and gently start releasing. Step off your hands nice and slowly. Now I want you to bring your hands to your hips and go up with a flat back. Very nice. Inhale those hands up overhead. And exhale, back and let it go. Inhale, hands up overhead. And let's fold that forward with the flat back. Very nice. Let's inhale, half lift. Extend that crown towards the front of the room. Exhale, let's fold it back into Uttanasana forward eight. Inhale, we're going to half lift. Sit down and crown towards the front of the room. Exhale, fold Uttanasana. Now you can rock or jump back into your plank position. Holding your plank strong. Remember, if you knees. Moving into our chaturanga, making sure our tailbone is tucked. We're going to draw halfway down, hugging our ribcage with the elbows, then bring it back up. Now dropping all the way down. Let's go ahead up and through to the upward facing dog. Our gaze goes up, draw the shoulders back down. And we're going to push into our shins and our feet. That's where our weight should be. Tuck those toes, lift your hips, and melt your hands, and melt your chest towards your thighs. Moving into our Devta Namaskar, salute to the gods and goddesses. We're kicking that right leg out to the sky. Now bend that right knee and swing it up and through, in between the hands. Drop to the knee, modify it. Eye gaze goes forward. Take your hands, and I want you to place them to your hips, making sure that your knee is stacked over your ankle. Now let's go ahead and lift up the flat back. Very nice. Let's drop down into that left knee. Untuck those back toes. Or you can keep them tucked for a little bit of the balance challenge. Inhale those hands up overhead. Draw those shoulders back and down. Place your hands together in a prayer position. That's interlacing your hands. Let's go ahead, making sure the shoulders are drawn back and down. Tuck in. Let's lift up. Actually, give it some room. Inhale it up, and then exhale, tucking our chin to our chest, bringing our forehead into a knee, mountain curl. You really want to draw in the belly up into your spine. Chin to chest, forehead to your knee. This is creating that great ball sensation. If you need a little bit of stability here, you can put your hands down to frame your foot. And wherever you are, keeping our shoulders next to our biceps, we're going to wheel our sword up to the sky. Now from here, I want you to place your hands to your hips. Drop those hips down low, shift them forward, and give a slight back bend. Let it go. Let's inhale to center. Let's windmill those hands to frame your foot. We're going to tuck those back toes, come up off that back knee, and then kick that right foot back to the left into our plank position. Now, chaturanga, you guys, drop into the knees to modify. Halfway down, then back up, and down, up and through for upward facing dog. Gaze goes up, draw the shoulders back and down. And let's tap those toes. Now the chest towards the thighs into our downward dog position. Relaxing into your downward dog. Take a couple breaths. Inhale through the nose. Exhale through the nose. Now let's take that left leg up to the sky. Draw that left leg in. Bend that left knee. Swing it up and through in between the hands. You can always drop to the knee, modify. Our knees goes forward. We're bringing our hands to our hips and our foot up and flat out. Now let's from here, I want you to carefully inhale those hands up overhead, draw the shoulders back and down, and let's drop down to that back knee. Untuck those back toes. If you like a balance challenge, keep those toes tucked. Place your hands together in a prayer position. Interlacing the hands. Inhale, give it some room. Exhale, chin to chest, grounding and curling the arms, lift it to your knee. Hands can stay hovered, but the foot are free, the foot for more stability. And place the hands together in a prayer position, hovering over the foot. Keep our shoulders against our biceps. We're going to wheel the legs forward, up to the sky. Allow the hands to fall to the hips. And let's shift those hips forward and give them a slight up bend. Center. Let's windmill those hands to frame the foot. Let's cut off of that back knee. Turn those back toes, move off that back knee. Kick that left foot back to your right into your plank. Holding your plank strong. Now try the long leg legs. Halfway down. Then back up. Then down, up and through. For upward facing dog. High gaze goes up, shoulders back and down. Now let's tuck those toes, lift the hips, and melt the chest towards the thighs. This is our nice resting position. Focus on your breath. Now let's roll those hands back to meet the feet. Allow the head to hang heavy. This is your Uttanasana, forward fold. Shake again, shift again. Breathe round and curl up, one vertebrae at a time. Inhale, hands up, overhead. Exhale, back and let go. Very nice. Inhale, hands up overhead. Draw those shoulders back and down. Moving into our Ardha Shavasana. I'm going to face you guys for this. Our hands are face up. Then I want you to tuck in your tailbone. So really get a nice tuck. From here, you're going to take your right hand. Right palm, face up towards the ceiling. You're going to take your left hand and grab onto your right wrist. Now with that tailbone tucked, nice and tight, you're going to extend all the way up to the ceiling. As far as you can go. Now, I want you to extend those hips out to the right side of the room, about an inch. Now we're going to hinge over to the left. Really opening up that shoulder, exposing our throat to the mirror or to the front of the room. We want throat nice and exposed. Now let's get in and up, and we're going to switch our grip. This is Ardha Shavasana, the half moon. We're placing our left palm face up, facing the ceiling this time. We're tucking in that tailbone. We're extending our hands up to the sky. We're extending our hips to the left side of the room this time. Let's make sure our throat is visible. And we're going to start hinging over to the right side of the room, exposing that throat. Make sure that shoulder is not rolling forward. Now inhale it up. And exhale, allow your hands to fall, make sure that you're trying to get the forearms to disappear behind the calves. And just like the Uttanasana from the front, you really want to extend those hips forward above the head. Wherever you are, carefully and gently step off those hands or release those hands to the floor. Remember, you can have knees bent as much as you need. Now we're going to round up on the ground time. Inhale, hands up overhead. Exhale, back and let go. Inhale, hands up overhead, and let's bring those hands to a prayer position. Bring them over your third eye. Now let them fall to your chest. Into a nice prayer position. We're going to come back to our intention. That's our word, our phrase. That word you set to help you get through with your personal practice. Let's come back to it. Make you a little bit stronger. We're giving our words strength by inhaling through the nose and exhaling through the nose. We just create all this energy. Let's sit in somewhere positive. Now I want you to open those eyes, inhale those hands up overhead, and we're going to need to make a nice back bend. So I want you to place your hands, take your hands, and place them behind your back. Now from here, you're going to have your hands in either a fist position, palms face up. Whatever is most comfortable to you. So, wherever you are, as long as that lower back is nice and supported, you want a good grip in whatever hand position you choose. Okay. From here, you're going to tuck that elbow. Bring those shoulders back and down. I want you to send your eye gaze to your feet. From your feet, I want you to start looking forward to the front of the floor and then to the front wall in front of you. Now, from the front wall all the way up the front ceiling, all the way to the ceiling. Now we're going to go all the way back towards the back of the ceiling and try to fall behind the back wall. Once you got to that comfortable position, we're going to try to open up that chest. Really allow yourself to be exposed. Now carefully and gently, the same way that we looked, going back, we need to follow that, going forward. All the way back to your feet. Allow your hands to fall to your sides. Inhale, hands up overhead. Draw the shoulders back and down. And exhale, long dive forward through the flat back. Come into that Uttanasana forward fold. Allow the head to shake. Yes, shake it down. And I want you to be half lift, so we're going to expand that crown of the head towards that front wall, lifting up halfway. Now fold it down on your exhale. And place those hands flat on the mat, and you can step back or jump back into your position. Make sure that tailbone's nice and tucked. You want a nice flat plank. If I were a weight, I want to be able to come and sit on your thighs. I want you to think you're that strong. Okay, now we're gonna bend down halfway, hugging the ribcage with the elbows, then back up for a chaturanga. Bend down, up and through for another face dog. Eye face goes up, bring the shoulders back and down. Now let's tuck those toes, lift those hips, and melt the chest towards the thighs, and to your downward dog. Now before we move into our warrior series, I want you to go ahead, shift your body weight forward, come onto those knees, and let's take a nice little break. You can grab a sip of water, resituate your mat, whatever you need to do. We're going to be taking that just like 1 minute break, and then move on from there.
Right thigh with that right hand. Now,
position. I think I want to spend 95 for you. But it's a 90 degree position. And we're going to take that right leg back to meet your left into your plank. Holding your hips strong, tucking your mat toe down. Now halfway down, hugging in the cage with the elbows. Then back up. Then down, up and through for an upward facing dog. High gaze goes up, shoulders back and down. We're placing our weight into those shins and into the feet. Now tuck those toes, lift the hips, and melt the chest towards the thighs. Coming into our downward dog, our nice resting position. Let's come back to our breath. Inhale through the nose, and exhale through the nose. Now we're going to extend that left leg up towards the ceiling. Bend up that left knee, swing it up and through in between the hands. Back knees goes forward. Now I'm going to be facing you this time, so you guys should be able to see all my positions and movements. So we're going to go ahead, place that back right foot at a 90 degree angle. We're taking our left hand and placing it to the inside of our left foot. We're taking our right hand and we're windmilling it up and through into our warrior two. Palms face up. And high gaze goes forward. We're going to draw those shoulders back and down. We're going to set low into our warrior two. Make sure that tailbone is nice and tucked. Now holding this strong. 4, 3, 2, 1. Left hand comes to the inside of that left thigh. Right hand comes up to the ceiling. Now we want to open up that left thigh with that left hand. While we're simultaneously bringing our shoulders back and down. Now sit a little bit deeper. And let's move back into our warrior two. Now reverse it. Right hand goes to that back thigh. Left hand goes up to the sky. And we're holding it for 3, 2, 1, hands come to warrior two, and we windmill those hands to bring the foot, untuck those back toes, and kick that left leg back to meet your right into your plank position. Hold your plank strong, tuck in your tailbone. Now, chaturanga, you guys, halfway down, then back up, then down, up and through. For upward facing dog. Now let's tuck those toes, lift those hips, and melt the chest towards the thighs. Focus on your breath. Inhale through the nose. Exhale through the nose. Now let's shift our body weight forward. Come down to our knees. Let's walk our knees up, hips distance apart. And when I mean hips distance apart, I mean like about 2 fist distance in between your hips. Now from here, we're going to keep our toes tucked. We're going to walk our hands back. To set our booty on our heels. Now for this, I want you to inhale your hands up overhead, shift your body weight forward, come back into that tabletop position. Now I want you to place your knees together, place your feet together, keep those toes tucked, walk those hands, pass them into the arms. You're getting a nice good stretch here. This is cutting off any lower extremities, blood circulation, creating new blood flow back in. Now we're going to inhale those hands up overhead. Draw your weight forward, allow those hands to go to a nice tabletop position. Spread those knees out, hips distance apart, back to the fist distance. Now we're going to pat those feet onto the mat, and let's create that new blood flow. Let's get back into those lower extremities. Very nice. And then we're going to go ahead and stop. From here, I want you to tuck those toes. Lift those hips and drop your chest towards the thighs into your downward dog. We're going to be moving into a little bit of a hip rotation series. We have some stamping to do, and then we'll be on the floor. We don't have too much time to go, so let's see what all we can accomplish. Let's kick that right leg back towards that back wall. Now from here, I want you to stack your hips on top of each other. Extend that foot up to the ceiling as far as it will go, but make sure you keep your shoulders square. Now I want you to bend at that right knee and look over your left shoulder to find those big toes. Keeping those shoulders square, and you want all of your weight on this side. You want it nice and square. Now, you're going to swing that foot up and through, but instead you're going to place your foot underneath your heart. So you're swinging that right foot and dropping it underneath your heart center. Now we're taking that back foot, that back left foot, and we're placing it at a 45-degree angle. We're placing our hands to our hips, and we're going up with the flat back. Very nice. Focus on your breath. Inhaling through the nose, exhaling through the nose. Now I want you to make sure that you have a nice foot placement going on. If you're short like me, maybe you need to go up just a little bit. If you're tall, maybe you need to send that foot out a little bit. Your feet should be at a 1 to 2 feet distance between each other. You're bringing your hands to your hips. Now to square your hips to the front of the room. So your right hip will go back. Your left hip will go forward. That back foot is at a nice 45-degree angle. That right foot is facing the front wall. Inhale, hands up overhead. Draw those shoulders back and down. Now, I want you to bring your right hand to your hip. Keeping your left hand up in the sky, I want you to hinge forward with a flat back. Very nice. And I want you to bring that hand and place it on top of that right shin. Now, I want you to start opening up that chest towards the right wall. Once your chest is open and your shoulders are stacked on top of each other, you can send that hand up to the sky, but only if your shoulders are stacked. I do usually teach this with a block. I do realize most of you don't have blocks. You can always use a book at home. And instead, you come halfway in, drop your book or your block on the side of your right foot. And then you're going to place your hand on top of your block, stacking your shoulder on top of your hand, and then sending that hand up to the sky once everything's stacked on top of each other. If not, you're just opening up that chest. If you don't have a block, we're going to try to do it with our hand on our shin. my shoulders square. I want you to bend at that left knee. Look over the right shoulder. Find those big toes. Now we're going to bend at that left knee and swing that foot up and through, dropping that left foot underneath your heart center, directly underneath your heart. Take that back foot and place it to a 45 degree angle. Take your hands to your hips. Let's pull up the flat back. Very nice. Now we're going to inhale our hands up overhead. Draw our shoulders up and down. Place our left hand to our hip. Take your right hand and let's start hinging forward with a flat back. Very nice. Let's take that hand, place it to the chin, and let's start opening up that chest towards that left wall. Once the shoulders are stacked, and only if they're stacked, send that left hand up to the sky. If you have your block, or even a book, you're going to hinge down with a flat back, dropping that book or that block next to your left foot, stacking the hand on top of the block, shoulder on top of the hand, and then rotating, opening up that chest towards that left wall, and then stacking the shoulders and opening up that hand, sending it up to the sky. Carefully and gently, let's drop your hands, just bring your foot wherever you are. Let's walk those hands forward a bit. Take that left foot back to meet your right into a plank position. Now I want you to bend at those knees. And we're going to go ahead, start walking our hands back. Setting our hips on our feet. This time, allow your feet to go flat. And let's go ahead, sit all the way to our knees. Swing those feet forward to a nice crisscross position. We don't have too much more time left, so we can go ahead and play on the floor a little bit. From here, let's do a couple of stretches by inhaling the hands up overhead. Draw the shoulders back and down. Now we're going to allow that right hand to fall behind our back. Our eye is staying forward. Now from here, we're going to send our left hand on top of our right thigh. Now, send your eye gaze back towards your right shoulder, but don't let it pass your right shoulder. Just get a nice side stretch here. Looking back, remember you never want your eye gaze to go past your shoulder. Now inhale, that left hand up to the sky, right hand follows. Now exhale, drop that left hand coming back. And drop that right hand on top of that left thigh this time. Eye gaze goes back towards that left shoulder, opening up to the ribcage. Inhale, right hand goes up, left hand follows. Exhale, let's cactus those arms, letting go. Now inhale, hands up. Hands to the back, come together to a prayer position, look at your heart center. Now, this may not be taught a lot, but I do like symmetry. So, since my right leg is above my left leg, if that makes sense, my legs are crisscrossed. This leg looks like we have a little bit more time left, so we can do some floor poses, laying in your shavasana. You're going to allow your hands to sway out to the sides of the room. Palms face up to receive energy. Palms face down to give energy back into Mother Earth. Bringing your shoulders back and down and keeping a slight tuck in your chin will help elongate your spine onto the mat. Relaxing into your shavasana. Now let's go ahead and bend in our right knee, bringing our knee into our chest. You're going to take your hands and interlace your hands over your right shin. You're going to keep both of your feet flexed towards your face. This is Padmasana on the right side. This helps with any digestive issues you may be having. So we inhale, give it a little bit of room. And we exhale, bringing the knee into the chest or into the armpit area. We inhale, give it a little room. Exhale, bringing it into the body. Inhale, give it a little room. Exhale, bringing it into the body. This is massaging our ascending colon. Inhale, give it a little room. Exhale, bringing it into the body. On our exhales are when we're the most flexible. Let's do it one more time. Inhale, give it a little room. Exhale, bringing it into the body. And let's hold it there as far as we go. For 3, 2, 1, let's release our grip. Send our right foot up towards the ceiling. Now, I want you to send your left foot up towards your right foot. Now, from here, I want you to bend on both of your knees. Take your hands, interlace them over both of your shins. Now, keeping your feet flexed, I want you to give yourself a little bit of a hug by tucking your chin into your chest and bringing your forehead to your knees. Exhale, release it down, allowing that head to fall gently back to the mat. Now, I want you to inhale, give a little room, and exhale, bring both of those knees into the chest. Inhale, give it a little room. Extend those feet out and exhale, bring those knees into the chest. This helps with our digestive issues. This is our transverse colon. We inhale, give it a little room. Exhale, bringing it into the body. Go at your own pace, at your own breath. Now carefully and gently, we're going to inhale, give it a little room. Exhale, bring it into the body. Let's hold it there. For 3, 2, 1. Release your grips and both of those feet up towards the sky. Now allow that right foot to fall carefully and gently down to the mat. We're going to bend on that left knee, take our hands, interlace them over that left shin. Make sure both feet are flexed towards the face. Now inhale, give it a little room. Exhale, bringing it into the body. Go at your own breath here. Remember, on our exhales, our room is most flexible. This is massaging our descending pole. This is the Padmasana on the left side, when liberation comes. And inhale, give it a little room. Exhale, bring it into the body. Inhale, give a little room. Exhale, bring it into the body. Let's relax into our Shavasana today. This is our last Shavasana class. Come back to your word, back to your intention. And realize that you accomplished it. You came here and you did it. You got your morning workout in, and now you can be productive with the rest of your day. Please feel free to stay relaxing in your Shavasana. If there's something that we did not work on, you can work on it. I'm going to go ahead. I think our